What I am standing on are an abundant series of fumaroles, hot springs, and mud ponds which are heated by and thus powered by a body of magma at about 5 kilometers or 3.1 miles depth. Now, the magma chamber in question is not specifically centered beneath this particular geothermal area known as Caldera Furnas, but rather underneath a volcanic crater known as Gaspar Crater 2 kilometers to the southwest. In other words, there may not be magma 5,000 meters below ground directly beneath these geothermal vents, but they are powered by vaguely nearby magma at 5 kilometers depth. All of these geothermal vents, volcanic craters, and lava domes represent the interior of an Azores volcano known as Furnas. As we zoom out, you can see the picturesque village of Furnas that lies within, along with the steep walls of two overlapping calderas formed by prehistoric, catastrophically large explosive volcanic eruptions. While all of the Azores Islands are volcanic in origin, with this fact being fairly obvious due to the occasional presence of lava tubes and volcanic craters, you don't necessarily feel like you are standing on a volcano unless you come to Furnas. And yet, despite the highest abundance of geothermal vents in the entire Azores island chain, the Furnas volcano wasn't the last volcano to erupt in the island group, let alone even on the same island it is based on, São Miguel. For reference, the Furnas volcano last erupted in 1630, causing widespread destruction, pyroclastic flows, and 195 fatalities. Yet, the Pacheco's Fissure System erupted in 1652, and Citations erupted 7 times since 1630, with the last eruption being a submarine eruption in 1880. What I am trying to say is that the Furnas volcano is not experiencing any unrest at the present, nor has it experienced unrest any time recently. It just has an implied very large magma chamber and hence a very large cluster of surface geothermal vents. But what exactly is the story and geologic history of this particularly explosive volcano? To start off, I want to first define the extent of the Furnas volcano. This volcanic edifice and its products cover 18.3% of the overall island, although only this smaller region has seen volcanic eruptions occur during the last 15,000 years. The Furnas volcano began erupting 93,000 years ago near the modern-day coastline to the south. Subsequent eruptions over tens of thousands of years built a stratovolcano that was preferentially centered towards the south, much like an old extinct volcano with its caldera exposed to the east. This stratovolcano grew to a height of what was likely 900 meters above sea level, with numerous basaltic cinder cones and trachyte lava domes dotting its flanks. The former originated in moderately explosive eruptions, while the latter generally represented the end phase of more highly explosive eruptions. Eventually, a large magma chamber began building underneath the volcano, which became increasingly pressurized and differentiated. Then, 30,000 years ago, this pressure was finally released via a massive eruption. Pyroclastic flows subsequently incinerated everything in at least a 7 kilometer radius, and while we do not know how much tephra was ejected, it was probably greater than 7 cubic kilometers but less than or equal to 17.5 cubic kilometers. Due to the large volume of molten rock that was ejected, a portion of Furnas's underlying magma chamber was drained. This caused the rock overlying its magma chamber to collapse downwards to fill the empty space, forming a 7.5 kilometer long and 5.8 kilometer wide caldera. Afterwards, for the next several thousand years, explosive Vulcanian and subplanean eruptions added height to the caldera floor. Then, 12,000 years ago, another massive eruption occurred, which once again drained so much of its magma chamber that another caldera formed. This time, the major eruption formed a 6 by 3.3 kilometer wide caldera. It is quite likely that at least a series of 1 to 4 eruptions during the next 7,000 years constructed a series of lava domes and at least one tuff cone at the edge of the outer caldera. In the last 5,000 years, at least 10 highly explosive volcanic eruptions occurred, all of which were planean or subplanean, rating on the Volcanic Explosivity Index as a 3, 4, or 5. Although the timings of not all of these eruptions are certain, here are the ages and locations of the known vents, with the modern geothermal area shown in the beginning of this video occurring within a large explosion crater formed in 80 CE. The 2.2 kilometer wide crater formed by Furnas Lake formed in 1170 CE, while this particularly large explosion crater and trachyte lava dome represented its 1630 eruption. That particular eruption was initially subplanean to planean, with a more than 14 kilometer high eruption plume, and fatalities occurring due to pyroclastic flows that reached 5 kilometers away at Ponta Grossa. The highly explosive phase of that eruption lasted for 3 days, followed by months of less explosive lava dome building activity. Despite the fact that the Furnas volcano has averaged an eruption every 500 years for the last 5,000 years, this is not a particularly strong metric for determining when its next eruption will occur. Furnas could theoretically erupt within the next few hundred years, or it could be another few thousand years if not longer. Regardless, it has not shown any recent signs of new life, and today serves as a scenic tourist attraction. I hope that you found this video interesting. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Danette Kublik, for supporting my work.